Hi, Gray.
Hi.
What did you do at school today?
It's going to school.
What did you learn?
Of the four seasons.
You learned about the four seasons?
Yeah.
What else?
Hmm.
What are you going to learn about tomorrow?
Chicks.
Chicks?
Yes.
They're going to bring eggs into your school and you're going to learn about the life cycle of a chick?
Yes, the life cycle on a chick.
Ooh. So it's the next day. I didn't end up vlogging anymore yesterday. The kids were overwhelming me and then Anthony came home. I made dinner and then I forced us all to go on a walk because I'm trying to get this baby out of me and she refuses to come. So we went for like over an hour walk yesterday, but I'm still pregnant. Nothing has changed. Gray went to preschool. He had a better day. He didn't have so good of a day yesterday at preschool, but he did better today. Porter's taking a nap. I'm about to go to my next doctor's appointment. I think it's like 38, although I'll be 39 weeks tomorrow. So it's like 38/39 week doctor's appointment. This time I'm meeting with the nurse practitioner because my doctor is on vacation. So I'm not really sure how this appointment's going to go or if anything's really going to happen. So I'll keep you guys updated. As of now, we're still on for being put on the wait list on Thursday. I'm hoping to get more clarity of what that exactly means and how likely is it that I will get induced on Thursday. I'm hoping they have like some insight on if there's been a lot of openings lately or if the hospital's been really busy lately. So I'm hoping to know. So I will let you know after my appointment what happens, but I'm hoping this is my last doctor's appointment. I'm hoping this is the last one. That would be really, really nice until my 6 week postpartum one, which whatever. Yeah, so I guess we'll just go to the appointment and see what happens. Hey guys, so I'm back from my appointment. I'm like out of breath. Basically, I have no update like usual. I have not dilated anymore. I'm still only 1 centimeter. She said I was like 30, maybe 50% effaced, but basically nothing. And unfortunately, like I was asking all these questions about how the whole waitlist thing works. And because she's a nurse practitioner, she really didn't have much to tell me. She didn't really know how it worked. So I have no more answers. That whole appointment was just pointless. I'm so annoyed. Every time I go, I'm disappointed by my doctor's office. I don't want to go anymore. I did make one more appointment for next Monday in case I don't get induced Thursday, Friday. I'm really hoping I'm going to get induced, but she said it's basically just if people who are induced end up going into labor on their own and spots open up, then that's how you'll get in. So I have to hope that people go into labor on their own. I hope that happens. If not, then I'm just stuck here pregnant forever. Super annoying. She was super nice though. Like I really liked talking to her, but just didn't really answer any of my questions. And she seemed actually kind of surprised that I was allowed to be induced. It sounds like because my second labor was so fast with Porter and I basically like almost had him in the car, that's how I'm able to get on the wait list. So that's the good side. That's how I'm able to get on the wait list. The bad side about my last labor being so fast was she refused to strip my membranes because she was worried that it would put me and make me like end up like spontaneously going into labor and then I have like a whole issue all over again with my doctor being out of town and everything else. That makes sense why I have not had my membranes stripped yet. Because I'm definitely dilated enough. I think you only have to be 1 centimeter, but because my labor was so fast last time, that is why I have not had them stripped yet. So I will keep you guys updated. Fingers crossed that I get a call on Thursday.
Porter, what are you doing? Is that your swing? No, whose swing is that?
Baby sister's.
Baby sister swing.
Yeah, baby Porter's swing.
Porter, you're not a baby. You're too big for that. You guys, this swing is like the number one plaything. Felix is, our cat is always in it. The boys are always in it. I hope the baby likes it as much as everyone else, because both of my boys did not care for the swing when they were little. And now it's all they want to play with.
Look.
Hi. So Gray's home from preschool. How are you, Gray? What'd you do today at preschool?
My teacher sent me an email.
She sent you an email?
Yes. This is Grayson. You are the server, a shower place from your wonderful pencil grip. Teacher, Mrs. Ucker, yay. Sweet, 29, 23.
Gray is so proud because he got a letter, or like a good note from his teacher saying that he held his pencil really well today.
Oh, yay!
He's very proud of it.
Oh, yay!
And what else did you do today at preschool?
I don't know.
You don't know?
Look at this.
What? Well, what are you doing? You guys, I have blankets. I have a blanket basket over there where the blankets are supposed to be. And the blankets are never in the basket. They're everywhere but the basket.
Look at this.
What? Gray is very into Ariel lately. And I'm always Ursula the Sea Witch, which is lovely. Hello, you guys. I feel like I'm vlogging like every single day. But I guess leading up to this hopeful induction. So today is Wednesday. Sorry, I was putting dishes in the sink. Today is Wednesday, March 29th. I am officially 39 weeks pregnant today. I am hoping that tomorrow is my induction day. So I'm hoping that tomorrow I get the call from the hospital that it is go time and that I am ready to be induced. I will be very disappointed if I receive no call tomorrow and no induction. I just want to do it and get it done with. So we will see if it happens, but I'm going to assume that it's on. And so I've been running around this morning trying to get the house ready. I've been cleaning the floors, cleaning off the countertops. I need to clean the bathroom. I packed suitcases for the boys because my parents are going to take them for a couple days whenever I do end up having this baby. Anthony packed his stuff in the suitcase, so that's all basically ready to go except for like last minute stuff like toothbrush and toothpaste and whatever. I got like little baskets ready for the downstairs bathroom here and for our upstairs bathroom and filled them with pads, Dermaplast, which is like numbing spray, Tucks, and like squirt bottles. So those are all ready to go. So I'm doing laundry today, washing all the dirty clothes so we can have clean clothes and I don't have to worry about that for a little bit after we get back. So I am preparing like today is my last day being pregnant and I really hope that's true. It's just so up in the air and I hate that. Anthony has told his boss that tomorrow might be the day, so he is ready to go. His work is prepared. Kind of crazy because I think the call comes at like 9 if they have room. And so it's like, do I do work? Do I not? So, and I have to take Gray to preschool, so it's just going to be chaos tomorrow. I don't know if I'm going to be able to sleep tonight. I slept okay last night. I slept until 5 a.m. Then I had to pee and then I just couldn't go back to sleep because I just kept thinking about like, is tomorrow going to be the day that I'm induced? I really hope so. I think having a birthday on March 30th would be awesome. Like that sounds so cool. So we will see. I'm excited. I'm nervous. I'm just like a bundle of emotions. We'll see how it goes, but I'm trying to get as prepared as I can. And just do as many things as I can beforehand. I went and got like groceries yesterday, so that's basically stocked. And my parents are on standby. They're ready to take the kids when need be. So I hope that tomorrow is the day. So we'll see, but I'll keep you guys updated and I'll just vlog here and there. But I just feel like every day I just am like, oh, I should pull the camera out because this is leading up to a really big event in everyone's lives, so the boys don't even know what's about to come, so I'm excited.